Craven, Missouri, Oklahoma City looks so, so pretty.
Start of Route 66!
Mexico, Flagstaff, Arizona, don't forget we're known as King.
And here we are, guys. The clock is ticking on the first mile of 2,200 odd miles all the way to Santa Monica.
And I have to basically drive and look at the computer at the same time because Bubba over here gets too sick and can't look at anything. And there's glare and there's this and there's that. So he'd rather risk us crashing than having it do it.
It's Bubba Gump here. Here is the real Route 66 in front of you between Chicago and Springfield, and a good example of where it runs parallel with the new modern freeway.
When we cross through St. Louis, Joplin, Missouri, Oklahoma City looks so, so pretty.
Hi folks, John Gump Golfin reporting from Pontiac in Illinois. I have with me Rose, and we're sitting in the Route 66 Museum Hall of Fame, quite a popular stop along Route 66. We just left Chicago this morning. We're about 90 miles, I think, roughly, out of Chicago. We've driven a lot of the original road next to the freeway, and I wanted to ask Rose, how long has the Hall of Fame been functioning?
Since 2004.
And how did it get started? Who started it?
Just, we have a Route 66 Association.
Right.
And they take care of everything. If somebody wants to donate something, it has to go before the association.
Right. Well, Rose, are you, by the way, are you from Pontiac?
Yes, I am.
From the area?
I've worked here 5 years.
Fantastic. And were you born in the area and raised here?
No, not here.
Right,
but
okay.
Not very far. Don't mind sometimes if you're at the food, at
the car wash. Hey, Christina, can you tell us what kind of pies you've got here?
This one's blueberry. We have strawberry rhubarb, cherry, peach, cherry apple.
Route 66 was obviously very important commercially as well, right? Because it connected Chicago with Los Angeles.
Right.
Do you think that's why it was so important? Or do you think other things made it important as well?
It's just the nostalgia,
right,
along the way, and
yep,
what is kept up, and as you'll see if you go all the way, there's
yeah,
several things that have been,
right,
been kept up.
And I know we're somewhere...
Somewhere in the middle there, yeah.
Beautiful. And then we're going to head all the sort of way down Oklahoma, Albuquerque, I think, and then just below Las Vegas into Los Angeles. Is that right?
Uh-huh.
Fantastic.
One thing that had a big effect on it was the movie Cars.
Huh?
Because that was on 66.
Right.
Presumably on 66.
We found out that there's a lot of U.S. troops in Afghanistan,
mm-hmm,
but we wanted to find out where that was.
I don't know exactly.
Coming to propose peace.
Abolishing slavery settles the fate for the millions now in bondage, and unborn millions to come.
It's either the amendment or this Confederate peace. You cannot have both.
Slavery, sir, it's done.
Even if every Republican votes yes, we'd still be 20 votes short.
Only 20?
Slavery is the only insult to natural law.
It's often referred to as the Mother Road. Why is that? Why do people call it that?
That was came out of a book, The Grapes of Wrath.
Oh.
That's where that came from.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Buy the votes.
Let me see what you can do.
Think of all the boys who'll die if you don't make peace.
I can't end this war until we cure ourselves of slavery. This amendment is that cure.
We need two yeses.
Get the hell out of here and get them.
But how?
I am the President of the United States, clothed in immense power.
Rose, I must thank you very much indeed.
Very well.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Here in my car, I feel safe as the roll. I can lock all my doors. It's the only way to live in cars.
G'day there, g'day viewers, John Gump Golfin. Welcome to Route 66, we're just outside of Springfield, heading towards St. Louis, and guess what we found? The exact original Route 66 road, built in 1926. And we know it's original because Rose told us to look out for a red road made of bricks. And here it is. Look guys, have a look at this. This is what a new brick looks like. This is what the original worn bricks look like. The original Route 66 was made of brick. She actually showed us this back in Pontiac, where the museum was. So this is an absolutely incredible find. Absolute original section. As you can see, it proceeds for not too far. If you look down the road, you can see where it ends. Fantastic. Thanks for that, we'll catch up with them. Hi there, are you from Australia? So are we. Here, just outside of Miami in Oklahoma, about 5 miles. I just wanted to show you the narrowest piece of Route 66. It's up 9 meters across from white line to white line and goes for about 2.5 miles.
Massive tornado ripped through a town in suburban Oklahoma City. The tornado was at least a half mile wide, and its 200 mile an hour winds flattened entire neighborhoods in Moore, Oklahoma. Many of them were students at an elementary school that the tornado ripped to shreds, while teachers and students huddled inside.
Our hearts are just broken for the parents that are wondering the state of their children that have been in the schools that have been hit today.
The loss you feel must not paralyze your own lives. Instead, you must try to pay tribute to your loved ones by continuing to do all the things they left undone, thus ensuring they did not die in vain.
Hi folks, John Gump Golfin here at the Chuck House in Oklahoma City. And we're about to have the world famous chicken fried steak, which is the number one dish in this city. And the way you order it here is by phone. You pick up the phone, I'll have a chicken fried steak please. And then it arrives. This chicken fried steak is actually beef, breaded, deep fried, then with this special white gravy, these chips, and what's called buffalo toast. So, cholesterol, here I come. From coast to coast, from east to west, I know for sure you are the best. Hi folks, John Gump Golfin here on Route 66, and we have Tom and Felicia, and they've actually travelled Route 66. Hi folks, John Gump Golfin reporting from Clinton, Oklahoma. Welcome to the modern Route 66 Museum. What did it mean to you, that experience?
It's a nice road. We would take it to go, we used to live in Mount Olive, and we take it to go to Litchfield to do our shopping.
Right. And how about yourself, Felicia? Have you done more of 66?
Yeah. There's actually a part that goes to Staunton too.
Right, okay.
And we used to go to Sotheby's all the time. That's like a landmark now.
Yep.
And it was very nice.
I'm here with Roswitha from Liechtenstein, believe it or not. And she's part of a group of many people on bikes, Harley Davidsons. And these are the guys that we followed to get here today because we kept getting lost. Roswitha, how many people in your group, do you know?
26 people in our group.
26?
And 6 nations.
So I wanted to ask you, why did you do this?
It's also a dream of us, for my husband and me. And now, this year, we are 25 years married.
Oh, wow.
And this is our gift.
Oh. 25 years anniversary. Congratulations.
Thank you.
From east to west, I know for sure you are the best. From coast to coast, from east. Hi folks, John Gump Golfin reporting from Texola, a small little town right on the border of Oklahoma and Texas. I have Marcel with me, who is the proprietor of this lovely little cafe and art gallery. And you've been here long?
5 years.
5 years, and what's it like?
It's boring. There's nothing to do here, really.
It's a different type of artwork. Would you like to explain it to us, Michelle?
It starts cowboys bringing house calls into me, and then I started painting the artwork on it. It's a lamp.
Yeah, red-tailed hawks. Yeah, are they around here? The
yes, they are.
Okay. And this one is obviously very topical for
this
us.
One, yes, I did as a Route 66. It's a Chevrolet, 62 Chevrolet.
Chevrolet. Nice to meet you too. Where is Afghanistan on this map? I can't spot it. Is can you guys see it? I think it's small. It's very, very small. Anyway, no, I can't see it either.
No matter. So we'll save that up for somebody further down the road. Thank you very much, Felicia. Thank you, Tom. Thank you very, very much. Have yourselves a great day.
Hi, folks. John Gump Golfin reporting from Amarillo in Texas along Route 66. I just wanted to show you this, a 72-ounce steak, in our terms, 2 kilograms. You can see how thick this monster is and how big it is. You eat this thing in 1 hour, along with that salad, that baked potato and the prawns in there, and it's yours for free. From coast to coast. So folks, I'm going for it. Reporting from Adrian in Texas, the midpoint of the Route 66 journey. And I'm with Malcolm from good old England. Why are you doing this trip?
It's a lifelong dream. And it's coming true.
And how do you feel about being halfway?
Sad, because we're on our way home. I am with our group, the Black Horse Riders.
The Black Horse Riders, and of course they're standing right behind us. Camera,
yes.
There are the Black Horse Riders right here. So Black Horse Riders, where are you all from? Who's from England?
Oh,
you're all from England. What are some of the other reasons why you've decided to travel this route?
Looking back, all those people over the years have travelled around from the Mars, from history, nostalgia,
yeah.
The dog collars.
I love that. I can't see the connection between dog collars and nostalgia.
If you're English, you understand it.
So thank you very much for being part of the filming, and enjoy your break. And enjoy the rest of your trip.
Thank you.
Hopefully we won't crash into one another.
That's
great. Thanks very much.
think he's looking at my shirt.
Hi folks, John Gump Golfin here from the Petrified National Forest in Arizona. This used to be a tree millions of years ago, and as you can see, it is now rock. So come a bit closer so you can have a look at the graininess of the rock.
Hi folks, what you see in front of you is the tree stump. And then up here, I'm going to show you the three different types of petrified rock, which depend on the material that actually got petrified. This is the red style, which is a certain type of tree back then, millions of years ago. The black one, because there was a different type of tree. And then the grey one. And you find this all over the place here.
I'm trying to find Afghanistan. Do you know where it is? Do you recognize any of these countries? No? If you want what's forbidden, baby, that's what I got. Sex drive. It sees no gender, but cholesterol. Get together and collide with each other. Sex drive. folks, John Gump Golfin here, reporting from the Grand Canyon in Arizona. On average, the Grand Canyon is 456 kilometres long by 33 kilometres wide, and we're standing at the top of it at 7,000 feet above sea level, and the Colorado River that you see down below is at 4,000 feet, and that means a difference of 3,000 feet, which we're going to hike to tomorrow. Folks, John Gump Golfin reporting from Grand Canyon, Southern Rim, Arizona. Here is the Bright Angel Trail that I ran. It starts at this little green mark here and descends 1,340 meters all the way down to the Colorado. Ran down this valley here ...12.9 km to the river right there.
Hi folks, John Gump Golfin reporting from the Colorado River, bottom of the Grand Canyon. The Colorado River runs for 2,250 kilometers from the Rockies way up there, right down to the Gulf of California. Center point towers. Back. See you at the top.
This is where I swam, and then my 12.9K run all the way back.
Hi folks, John Gump Golfin back from the Bright Angel Trail. Took about 2 hours 45 minutes from the Colorado River, 2 hours 15 minutes going down. A hell of a distance for a bloody swim. Freezing cold water down there. So it's back to Route 66 tomorrow.
John Gump Golfin reporting from Williams in Arizona.
Terry McNeil.
Terry McNeil.
Buck Williams.
Buck Williams, what a great name that is.
John Nardini.
John. And do you guys get a lot of visitors?
The train that runs from here to the Grand Canyon every day has 15 cars and about 100 people in a car. And thanks for the whip.
The whips?
I'm seventh in the world with the whip, and I only use kangaroo hide. Oh. Kangaroo hide is much thinner.
Right.
Much lighter, yep. Easier to use, yep. And it's 4 to 7 times stronger than cow leather.
You're kidding.
Usually it's from the stomach.
From the stomach area.
Because that's already stretched.
Right, okay, got it. It makes a good whip, the best whip.
Oh, best whips in the world are
So we had to come to Williams to find out that Kangaroo Belly makes the best whip in the world.
There you go. There
fantastic. You go. What a gem of a fact. Thank you very much.
You got me down, man. You got me up, down, down, up, anywhere you want me, Doc. Baby, baby.
And I have with me Joe Clark. Joe, I wanted to ask you, are you from these parts? Were you born and raised here?
Born and raised in Scottsdale, and then I lived in Southern California for 29 years, a place called Laguna Beach.
Oh, yes, I know it. Yep.
Yeah, I lived there for 29 years, and then I used to come hunting up here with my father when I was, you know, about 8, 9 years old.
Yep.
So it got too pricey in Southern California, too expensive. So I bought a place up here, oh, God, almost 20 years ago.
Wow, 20 years.
One time, this town had 3 car dealerships and was the headquarters for Santa Fe Railroad, but they pulled out, and when I-40 came in, I pretty much shut it down. And then there was a guy, Aja Delgadillo, up the street. They started the historic Route 66 organization.
Right.
And that started bringing more life back to it. And there's an animated movie called Cars. I don't know if you've ever seen it.
No.
It's based on this town. That's helped bring this town back. Oh. You better slow than Mustang down.
And why do you think people come along Route 66?
Well, a lot of people, a lot of Americans anyway, it's memories. Especially after World War II, you know.
Yep.
People coming back from the service, from the, you know, especially from the Pacific, they all have to pass through.
Right.
So it's some nostalgia more than anything.
Right. Right.
Remember coming through here? I was probably 5 or 6 years old.
I guess if I was to describe Route 66 with one word, it would be nostalgia.
Yeah, that would definitely
probably
be
best word. Well, Joe, thank you very much.
Well, thank you. Enjoy the rest of the trip.
Thank you so much indeed. It was a pleasure talking to you.
Surely. All you want to do is ride around, Sally. Ride, Sally,
ride. All you want to do is ride around, Sally. This is George, the proprietor of this lovely old service station. George, I was going to ask you, are you from around here?
Originally from Minnesota.
Minnesota. And how many years have you been in this area?
Been in Arizona for 10 years, been managing this for 5. I'm gonna be wiping those
weeping eyes. And tell us a little bit about this place.
Cool Springs was a 1926 gas station. It was restored in 02 to 04. I sat for 50 years vacant, and the gentleman from Chicago restored it, wrote the check. Yep. Another gentleman built it, and I've been managing it.
Oh. Girl, you won't let me ride my Sally, my baby. So do you meet people stopping by?
All over the world. I get a lot of people from Australia. Well, I think a lot of Europeans think it's a basic part of the United States.
George, thank you very much. I really appreciate it.
If you ever plan to motor west, travel my way, take the highway, that's the best. Get your kicks on Route 66. It winds from Chicago to L.A. More than 2,000 miles all of the way. Get your kicks.
Hi folks, John Gump Golfin reporting from outer Los Angeles. It's our last day on Route 66. And I'm now navigating through all the LA suburbs down to the Santa Monica Pier, which is at the end. See you at Santa Monica Pier at the end sign.
Don't forget Winona,
Kingman, Bosco, San Bernardino.
Won't you get hip to this timely tip? When you make that California trip, get your kicks on
Route 66. We made it!
If you ever plan to motor west, go west, it's best, travel my way, take the highway, that's the best. Get your kicks on Route 66, Big Six, Six, it winds.
Route 69, we did it!
Cheers!
Thank you, Mullet and Shandong!
Get your kicks on Route 66.
Can we talk it over in bed? I never meant to hurt you. Must have been.
You did us a big honour to appear in our film.
Yeah, oh,
because so you're going all the way to Australia.
Oh,
you know, we're talking about 15,000 miles.
Ooh,
you'll be
tired, time I
in front
tired
of all the folks.
Peter, yeah, hello. You can't take Peter. We can't do that.